Ibrahim Lodi, an Afghan by blood, was the last leader of the Lodi administration. He succeeded his dad Sikandar Lodi yet couldn't coordinate his capacity as a ruler. He was born in 1480 AD. His rule continued from 1517 to 1526 AD. He died in 1526 AD and was succeeded by Babur. Ibrahim Lodi became the Sultan of Delhi in 1526. Ibrahim Lodi was the son of Sikandar Lodi, who after his father's death came to the throne without any opposition. He was killed in the First Battle of Panipat, which took place between his empire and Babur. His life, he brought the idea of dual monarchy, which was suppressed by Sikandar Lodi, was revived again by Ibrahim Lodi. Doing so after many warnings and perusals, he also installed his brother Jalal Khan as the independent ruler of Jaunpur even. Though his seniors did not like the idea of two brothers reigning the same kingdom. Later on, at the advice of his Wazirs about Jalal's misconduct, Ibrahim Lodi sent secret instructions to chief nobles and governors not to recognize Jalal Khan's authority. In the circumstances, Jalal Khan was compelled to leave Jaunpur and return to Kalpi. But soon he succeeded in recovering Awadh. Jalal was killed by Ibrahim's men and he claimed the whole empire. Ibrahim Lodi was a very cruel and high-headed ruler who was known for his atrocities. He even failed to have good relations with the nobles. He got them imprisoned and was also cruel to his officials and killed and poisoned many noblemen. Actually, however, Ibrahim was altogether different and was kind towards his subjects and holy people. He made strides for the change of agribusiness and both the state and the nobles got their share in products. Individuals carried on with a cheerful life because of abundance and modest cost. His cruelty paved way to rebel in various corners of his kingdom, due to which he faced a number of rebellions and secret enemies. Rana Sangram Singh, the ruler of Mewar, insulted Ibrahim by extending his empire up to western Uttar Pradesh and threatened to attack Agra. Supported by his prosperity against Gwalior, Ibrahim chose to overcome Mewar, whose ruler was Rana Sangar, an awesome warrior. The armed forces of Delhi met with a few turnaround. Ibrahim lost his distinction and asset. Unluckily for him, in 1526, one of his honorable Daulat Khan welcomed Babur to attack India and asked for him to take revenge from Ibrahim for their benefit. Babur reacted to his request and set out to meet the Sultan of Delhi. On reaching Ambala, Babur bravely planted his army without any fighting in a defensive position. For 8 days Babur waited for Ibrahim's army, and when they finally reached, they were astonished by the exclusive approach implanted by Babur. Babur's army was using the influential arms like the Turco-Mongol bows that made things worse for Ibrahim, as they were unaware of such weapons. Regardless of having an extraordinary number of vital points of interest, the Afghans lost the fight with the Mughals. However, Ibrahim was a courageous warrior. He inspired his armed force by driving his armed force from the front and gave his life in the war. The armed forces of Babur and Ibrahim Lodi conflicted with one another at Panipat on April 20, 1526, and Ibrahim, notwithstanding overpowering prevalence in numbers, was crushed and killed. Thus, the First Battle of Panipat, 1526, saw the foundation of the Mughal kingdom in India. His tomb is situated in near the Tehsil office in Panipat, right next to the Dargah of Sufi Saint Pure Ali Shah Qalandar.